everybody. Paul Diebold, Irvington Historical Society. We're here on Julian Avenue, just west of Emerson at Howe High School. Howe High School, of course, was the Irvington Community's high school. And we're gonna talk today a little bit about the story of how Irvington came to have its own high school. Of course, if we go back, remembering some of our past episodes here, we talked about Butler University. One of the things that Butler University did in Irvington was they had a college preparatory program, which meant that you could go to high school, essentially, at Butler. And then, of course, you could follow up and go to college at Butler. And I'm sure as a student, you would have loved to say, I stayed at the same school for 7 or 8 years. I'm sure at that time that would have been just a lot of fun for you. However, education was evolving. As the 19th century went on, people began to realize we're putting people out into the workforce, they need more education. And there were compulsory education laws, one in 1897 that raised the age, I think, to about 12. And then finally in 1913, we went to age 16, compulsory education. So that meant all of a sudden, many communities were scrambling to create enough high school space, and high school became, rather than thought of as something that was just an extra addition to your education, became thought of as something that was really pretty necessary for all American citizens. So with that, in 1913, Irvington families had a problem. Irvington was growing pretty rapidly at that time, probably had a thousand or so families in the area. We had been annexed to the city of Indianapolis, so families had to decide where they would send their children, and they were given a choice. They could go to Arsenal Technical High School, which was the high school on Michigan that was created out of the surplus U.S. Army armory buildings that had been converted into a quite sizable high school campus, still exists today. You could go to Shortridge, you could send your child to Shortridge, you could send your child to Manual, pretty much any of the IES schools, but those three seem to be the ones that were the most popular. So this really became kind of untenable by the time Butler University was planning to move from Irvington. In 1925 is really when that decision was made that they had outgrown the Irvington campus. In 1928, of course, they had completed Jordan Hall on the north side and moved there. And the Butler University officials, which included a number of prominent Irvington citizens, proposed that a similar thing could be done with the Butler University campus here in Irvington, as was done at Arsenal Technical High School. That is, convert the college buildings into a sizable high school campus that could serve Irvington. However, that was not viewed favorably by the community. There was still some animosity, I suppose, over Butler moving to the north side. And so eventually, citizens formed a committee and asked IPS to issue bonds to build an Irvington High School. And that is what Howe was first called in the 1920s. It was called the Irvington High School. It was not called Howe. I'll get into that in a minute. So in 1926, that proposal was brought forward. The architects McGuire and Shook, who planned School 82 not far away in Christian Park, they were hired and they drafted plans for a building, pretty much the building that is behind me. However, before bonds could be issued and construction could begin, the Depression hit. And so Irvington had a problem. We needed to continue to send our children elsewhere for their high school education. Finally, what happened is IPS was encouraged to apply for Works Progress Administration funds, WPA funds. WPA monies were part of the New Deal alphabet soup programs of Franklin Delano Roosevelt. And these programs were intended to get people back to work. So WPA monies didn't provide workers directly. It simply provided a grant to an existing project that had partial funding. And that was the case here at Howe. So then the 1928 plans were simply dusted off. Educational requirements really hadn't changed all that much. And the McGuire and Shook 1928 plans for an Irvington High School were adopted for the WPA project to build the building behind me. In the meantime, though, Thomas Carr Howe, very well-known community leader here in Irvington, had died in an automobile accident. And so very quickly, the community proposed we should name the high school for him because he was an advocate of Irvington getting its own high school. So the name was changed to from Irvington High School to Thomas Carr Howe High School. And so in 38, then the high school opened and so the classes in September, and it was very much a phased project. They knew that the building wouldn't be large enough, so they started with first freshmen and sophomores, and then as time went on, they added the other classes. Over to my right in this direction is the 1950s addition, 1954. Other additions were completed in 1963 and 1975. So also this site was known as Violet Hill, and it was a favorite sort of gathering spot. It was vacant ground at the time the high school was proposed. So that pretty much wraps up our program for today. Howe High School, of course, is in transition. The athletic facilities are being used by the Purdue Polytechnic High School, which is in the old Mallory plant further down Washington Street. The high school for right now is closed, so we'll be writing another chapter in history. Hopefully this building can be saved in some way. Well, have a great Saturday. We're looking forward to fall here. There's a chill in the air this morning, believe me. I've got a sweatshirt on today. And we'll see you next week. Take care, everybody. Stay safe.